Welcome to this week's video. This week's video, we're going to be talking, can you save money by charging your electric car at night? A couple of weeks ago, I did a video about can the grid cope, and one of those subjects was charging at night. Now, before I get into the video, please consider clicking subscribe down below. Click the little notification bell and you'll be alerted every time I upload a new video. And one thing I want you to do this week, which is completely different, that I've never asked you to do before, share it with a friend or family member and see if you can get them into electric cars by showing them the videos I make every single week about electric cars. So how do you save money? Just by plugging in a bit later. And how do you delay that charge rate? Now, there's a couple of ways of setting the charge delay on your car. One is you can set it directly on the system by using your app or on the actual dash. Now, if you're using a Renault Zoe, do it by the app. If you do it by the actual car, it can cause problems with the server syncing up correctly. So if you've got a Renault Zoe, sync it by the app. If you've got the Nissan Leaf, I believe it's completely fine. Whichever one you sync it on, I believe, if you sync it on the car or the app, it works absolutely fine. And obviously Tesla and all the other manufacturers. So if you can, set the time delay on the car and set it for the eco hours that you get, and that will delay the charge, only start the charges during those particular hours. Now, the original concept of the video is, can it save you money? Now, let's dive into the bills that I've got on my screen here, and we can go through that, exactly what I've been paying and what I've worked out I'm saving per month. So the tariff I'm on is the Octopus Go tariff. The Octopus Go tariff is 4 hours of cheap charging. So unlike Eco7, which is 7 hours, and then obviously you've got the rarer Eco10, which is obviously 10 hours, Octopus's Go tariff is 4 hours. So it's usually perfect for an Eco driver, a Nissan Leaf driver, or a Renault Zoe driver to top up enough of their daily commute. Now, if you've got the 3.6 kilowatt charging Nissan Leaf, if you're only doing a daily commute that requires you to charge those hours, that's usually sufficient to cover your daily commute. If you're wanting a full charging and a run constantly empty, yes, those 4 hours won't be enough to fully charge on a 3.6 kilowatt charger, but seeing your daily commute would usually be well within that, that's normally fine. And even then, for the extra 3 hours it might be charging, you'll be offsetting on the other 4 hours that you would be charging. Now, as you can see, with Octopus at the moment, I'm paying on this month, which is a December to January. Obviously, we had Christmas and I had Christmas lights on, etc., etc., etc. So more extreme use than I normally would in electricity. I ran an electricity bill up of £50. Now, I also was charging other EVs as well as my normal daily commuting EV. So I fully took full advantage of using as much power as I could during this. And there was also some off-peak use of high electricity charging, because I had to charge a Nissan Leaf I had for sale pretty quickly on a 7 kilowatt charger. Now, if you're picking an Eco7 or Eco10 tariff, you'll need an Eco10 or an Eco7 meter installing. And if you're going to Octopus Go, you'll need Octopus's Go smart meter. Now, they do share a smart meter with a lot of other companies. There's a picture of it I'm going to display now, so you can decide which one it is and if you've got that one that works with Octopus. If you haven't, they will install a free one. Now, the reason that you need a special and new meter is Octopus smart meter uses half an hour reading, so it needs half an hour meter base readings, and then Eco10 and Eco7 take a 7 hour window and a 10 hour window to work out what rate you're on. Now, smart meters take half an hour readings, and that's why Octopus are able to do half 12 to half 4, where normal smart meters kick on either at 12 or 1 o'clock, and that's why these tariffs are a little bit different. Now, if you want to become an Octopus Go customer, there's a link down below to a link that will give you £50 referral credit, so you'll get £50 credit on your first energy bill. Octopus also pay £50 for every friend you refer, so obviously that means I get 50 quid when you join as well. But I joined this tariff because I thought I could save money, and I wanted to make a video once I had a couple of months of data and worked out how much I was actually saving. And today we're going to go in depth in this bill, but this could also apply to Economy 7 and 10 tariffs. You just need to work out how many hours and what rates you're using, and if you have a smart meter, any smart meter from any company, you can work out when you're using electricity and do your calculations yourself. If you haven't got a smart meter, a little bit of guesswork's involved,
But I was always sceptical in the past on whether an Eco 7 tariff would save me money, but the one with the Octopus Go tariff, the actual standard rate day charge isn't that far off what I was paying anyway, but the nighttime tariff, I knew there was a massive drop there. So it was a bit of a risk when I joined Octopus on whether I was going to save money, but it's a risk that is definitely paying off. Now let's go straight in depth to my bill. Now if you can see on the Octopus Go tariff, it says on the right hand side your tariff rate and what you're paying, and then if you see on the left it says my smart meter readings, and it'll work out all the readings, and then it says energy use 474.7 kilowatt hours, and that was at 8.62 pence per kilowatt hour. Now the reason it says that is it works out the average from my smart meter readings, from my day rate and my night rate, and divides that by obviously the average, and works out the average kilowatt reading for the bill. So it makes comparison with other energy tariffs a lot easier, because I now know that because of what I use at night and during the day, my average is 8.52p per kilowatt. Now the only thing you might notice here, and a lot of people notice it straight away, is the standing charge is very high. It's 25p a day. Now that works out over a 33 day period on this bill as £7.86. So it's quite a high standing charge compared to some other providers, but it's not really that high when you consider how much you're going to pay per kilowatt. Now if we look into my in-depth sort of day by day, now every Octopus bill, when you've got a smart tariff, they will give you every single day of energy usage that you use. So if we look at this reading for the 2nd of December, you can see there I only used 68p of electricity, which was 5.32 kilowatts, and you can see there's basically a bar chart with when my energy was used, and you can see the purplish line across there. That's the cost of what I'm using per kilowatt. So you can see between sort of 12 and half 4, it's down at 5p, and then it jumps up to the higher rate cost, which is just under 14p for me. I think it's 13.68 pence or something like that. Now, Octopus's Go tariff varies depending where you are in the UK, but it's usually 5p off peak and then also 14p on peak. Now, like I said, it differentiates where you live, but it's usually about that, and you can email Octopus prior to switching to it and get exact rates on what you'll be on. We scroll over to the 13th of December. You can see here on the 13th of December, I had a lot of use. Now, I used 31.86 kilowatts of electricity, which is a fair amount of electricity, and that cost me £2.13. And you can see on the bar chart that the energy usage, obviously because of my time delay on my car, started at 12:30 and then it tailed off very quickly after about 1:30. There was still a little bit of usage near the end. Now the reason for the little bit of usage at the end is not only do I charge my car at night, I've also decided to put my dishwasher on, my washing machine, and any other electrical sources at night that I can use to charge up. Now you could even, if you wanted to go to the massive extremes, you could use smart plugs, which there is some listed down below in Amazon referral links to that. Now smart plugs, basically you can set the plug to only come on at certain times. So if you wanted your mobile phones or any other devices in your house just to charge at night, you can do that. Now most modern washing machines, modern dishwashers have time delays, and that's what I've done here. Apart from the time delay I said it wrong on my dishwasher, and that's why you've got a tail off near the end. But as you can see, the total cost of electricity is extremely cheap. Now the video obviously was titled about saving money, so let's dig into the figures here. Now if we just round the figures down nicely to, I use 474 kilowatts. Now because of the Octopus Go tariff, I averaged at 8.52p. Now if we just calculate that, we obviously know from the bill that it's about £40.48 for 474 kilowatts. Now let's just assume that you can buy your electricity at 12p a kilowatt, and that would work out for that amount of use, £56.88, which means I'd be saving £11.60 on the current Octopus deal. Now that's £11 over a month, over a year. It's not a lot of money. It's an amount of money, but it's not a lot of money. So today I just did a price comparison on what the cheapest energy was available anywhere on the market, green, non-green, everywhere. Just searched the entire market for variable tariffs, non-variable tariff, fixed tariffs. The Octopus Go, by the way, is fixed 12 months. I searched everywhere. And the cheapest one I could find was at 13.87p, but that's just for argument's sake of this conversion, round it down to 13p. So if it was 13p at 474 kilowatt hours of usage, that would be £61. So at the moment on Octopus Go, I'm saving £21 a month by charging my car at night and using other electronics. Now, even if I wasn't using the dishwasher and washing machine, there'd still be a big saving. There wouldn't be a £21 saving a month, but there would still be quite a significant saving there. And that is the thing about these tariffs, which let you switch your usage tonight. You can save a lot of money by just charging your car, but if you then start switching your dishwasher and any other energy use, that's even great. I mean, if you're using the dishwasher and washing machine during the day, yes, you're going to be paying peak price and not the off-peak price that's is at 5p, but even with that, your electric car, if you're charging up 20 kilowatts a day, that's to say your battery's right down to, you know, low percentage, or even charging 15 kilowatts a day, you're not going to use 15-20 kilowatts using the washing machine a couple of times a week, unless you have a large family with several kids, in which case you're going to have to recheck the figures, and even then you might want to switch your uses to using it at night, because the price drop would be amazing. So in summary, yes, I've saved quite a lot of money. I worked out about £25 a month from what I was paying before on the new Octopus Go tariff, and that is a considerable saving in my pocket. Now also with Octopus Go, every time I refer someone, I get 50 quid and they get 50 quid when they join. So if you get a couple of your friends and family to join, which is what I've done, so I'm my dad up, my sister, my gran, a couple of friends, my neighbours, my father-in-law, if you sign all these people with £50 a go, that credit in your account is an additional bonus on the saving you're going to make. I mean, I've this year had so many referrals just from family and friends, I'm going to have zero electricity bill. I mean, basically, I've got free electric and free gas for 12 months just off family and friends. So it's a great system, great company, UK call centres. Now, there is other Economy 7 tariffs and other tariffs that you can try, but I recommend personally Octopus Go for the customer service and also the price at 5p off-peak was the cheapest I could find anywhere else. All the others were slightly higher off-peak with a slightly sort of higher or near to what I'm paying now as the peak price. So thanks very much for watching this week's video. Don't forget to click subscribe, check out my other videos, and consider becoming a patron. Thanks very much, and I'll see you again next week. Goodbye.